report from, among others, Amnesty and Diakonia on the situation of the siege of Gaza. The exact situation that you can see in here is that the siege is actually continuing in a very upsetting way.
I think it could be good if you could also tell a little about the situation with the siege. Because half a year ago, after the Marmara drama, or whatever you want to call it, the attack, Israel promised, after heavy pressure from the world, to open the borders, at least to ease the siege, as it was. And as far as I have seen, there has been almost no easing at all. And I want you to give your picture of that, too.
I think, talking about the easings, during when Israel imposed its very strict closure, they had what's so called permitted list. So they made it public the kind of items that are allowed. So those are allowed, 30 or so items, and the rest are banned. Now with Tony Blair's involvement with the quartet, they have a new innovation called prohibited list. So everything is allowed except for those items that are not allowed. And items means construction material, which means as if they are just like Coca-Cola. Construction material, it is the main story. I remember when Ban Ki-moon visited Gaza, I had a chance to meet him. And I told him, look, Mr. Ban Ki-moon, you came after the war. We were expecting you to come during the war. However, you are here, ahlan wa sahlan, you're welcome. But and it's good to that you show solidarity. But how come you're? Because he talked a lot. He did not talk about accountability, by the way. He talked about reconstruction of Gaza. That we are committed to reconstruct Gaza. But would you please tell me how you will reconstruct Gaza while there is no single construction material is being allowed to? How come? And my second question: do you have guarantees that what if what you will build, what you will reconstruct, will not be redestroyed again from the Israelis? Because what has been destroyed, as I mentioned, is actually funded by the EU and the international donors community. The infrastructure, the schools, etc., was funded by the EU. So nobody has those guarantees. So, I mean, first we have to address this. To reconstruct Gaza is to allow construction material. And construction material is not an end by itself, even though it's important, because many thousands of families are still until this moment. We are in the winter, and 2 years after the war, or the aggression, I'm not saying war, because war means that two parties were fighting. After 2 years after the aggression on Gaza, people still did not rebuild their what has been destroyed, their homes, until this day. So it's beyond this, because the construction material will mean that the economic circle will move. 30 professions are dependent on this process. Carpenters, ironworks, aluminium, etc. 30 jobs or 30 professions are connected to the construction thing. So imagine how this will help the economy of Gaza. Especially, as I said, 100,000 used to cross on daily basis to Israel to sell their labor force in the Israeli labor market. They are not anymore working there. And business, small businesses and local industry has also been subjected to direct destruction or kind of dissolving through the restrictions on the import of raw materials and export of goods. So it's the easings, I think, yeah, there are some easings. If you go to a supermarket in Gaza, and instead of having one soft drink, you have 20. One chocolate item, you have 15.
Yeah.
Israeli one, so who is Money. Yes, yes, yeah, exactly. I mean, the unholy relation, again, continue. And this is I did not mention it, that in 67, the Israel was, if you go back to the literature, that was, I mean, they have this problem. They occupied Gaza and West Bank. What to do with the people, those youths? I think the Israeli economy was in a need for the cheap labor. It was a construction-based economy. In a later stage, it has been changed to be high-tech diamond industry and so there is no need for the cheap labor. And forget about politics and security. It's more related to the structural adjustment of the Israeli economy. And they have solved two problems. Security problem, those yachts, if they do not work, they will go for resistance. So let them go to work. So they work. So they work in Israel, they have shekels, they buy Israeli commodities. So the capital circle goes this way, but the accumulation is in Israel. So we work there, we have salaries by shekels, and we buy Israeli commodities. And no one, I mean, importing from outside is not an easy, I mean, items are not allowed to be imported. I mean, it used to be, and during the direct occupation with the PA, there were some changes. Even the Paris Protocol that was signed by the PA, which is the economic agreement between the PA, you know, they interferes on the size of the egg that's allowed to be imported, the size. Yeah, it's there in the area.
You didn't mention anything about Egypt.
To the Rafah and the Egypt, the role of Egypt, I think Egypt was trapped in the whole thing. On the one hand, what's happening in Gaza is of serious consequence on its national security, especially talking about Muslim Brothers and Muslim entity beside them. They are fighting Muslim Brothers internally. And you have, and finally, Gaza with Hamas is being viewed by the Egyptians that now Iran is in our borders. It's also something serious for them. That's how they put it. But I think there was exaggeration. I think during the war and after the war, we were saying very clearly, Egypt is not the state that occupies Gaza. There is one occupier and should not be shared with any. It's Israel. And borders should be open with Israel first. I mean, Rafah crossing is important, but we have other five crossings with Israel. Also should be open. But has been maximized somehow. Maximized by many to show that the Rafah crossing is the final destiny, the final goal, as if it's the problem. It is. It should be open, but there are other five crossings to be open, and I think the whole issue of Egypt has been viewed, and Egypt has been viewed to be part of the, or sharing Israel in this. Sometimes, yes, we have this, but in general, again, it's very, very, very serious and very dangerous that to fragment the responsibility. Gaza is occupied territory, and Israel is the occupier, and the occupier, according to international law, should ensure the prosperity and the well-being of the civilians in the occupied territories. Egypt should facilitate and the exit and the entry of the Palestinians. But here's the problem. I think some satellite stations have maximized this, viewing Egypt to be part of the problem. It's being abused, to be honest. But to be, if we put it rationally, I think, yeah, what's for Egypt is for Egypt, and what's for others should be for others. I cannot accept the argument that Rafah crossing, even though I am very much affected by the closure of Rafah crossing as a person from Gaza. But finally, this is just one crossing. There are five crossings. And I was my point of view, and I wrote in this and published it, that when Israel, when the idea of disengagement was, there was a debate within Israel, it was not yet implemented, I wrote something saying, Israel will disengage, and we have to maximize the engagement with the Israelis politically and legally. Because Israel cannot say finito after 40 years of occupation that, khalas, sorry, we have nothing to do with Gaza. They should assume the responsibility, and they should pay the consequence of 40 years of occupation, as simple as it is. So here is the problem. After the Marmara shipment, I think Rafah crossing was open, but still the criteria. And I think here is a problem, it's a dilemma. On the one hand, the Rafah crossing is working or functioned on the basis of understandings signed between the PA and the government of Israel with the presence of Sulana, Condoleezza Rice, and Wolf Finson, the World Bank, the chair of the World Bank. So there are guidelines and arrangements, and now with the changes in Gaza, the Egyptian state said clearly that the PA is not anymore there. We cannot function the crossing, but however they opened the crossing, now it's open. It's they close it only on from the last month only on Fridays and Saturdays, but the criteria is still the criteria. Those who need medical treatment and should have a valid permit from the Ministry of Health could go. Students.
Ministry of Health in Gaza.
Yes, or in Gaza and West Bank, and here is also those are from
so
the areas where there is sort of coordination, even little, but still, I mean, the areas of coordination between the governments is, for example, the Hajj, the belligerent to Mecca, was subjected to this coordination and was successful. The high school, the education, the what we call it, tawjihi, and the results, tanawiyya al-amma, it was coordinated. We have a unified exam for West Bank and Gaza, which is also is good. Again, the criteria is still the criteria. So Egypt still view the borders, the crossing, to be closed. But it's being opened de facto. Work on the criteria I just mentioned. Those who have a visa and a flight ticket also can cross. And those who can, lucky enough to do the coordination with the Egyptian authorities to cross, which is in the absence of the opening of the clause.
There is, for example, when there is a need to repair and improve the schools in Gaza. There is restrictions on cement and building material. It's still so that if the United Nations want to repair a school, it's a very hard and very long and very complicated process to do this. For any other person who would like to build a new house or a military bunker or whatever, they can just use the cement that is coming via the tunnels. Then of course you will have the de facto government by Hamas who will take some royalty on everything that is being smuggled in. But we have the totally unacceptable situation that what is humanitarian needs can actually not be performed while any other needs can be provided via the tunnel system. So you basically have a double moral system here. What we also have is that the humanitarian aid that is being provided to not only Gaza, but to the Palestinian territories in general here, that you will see Israeli products there.